It has been quite a while since we last witnessed a space plane, capable of orbiting the Earth, returning to the planet, and concluding its mission by landing on a runway. In fact, the last time we observed such a feat was a decade ago with the space shuttle. However, there is a possibility that we may soon revisit those remarkable moments. Sierra Space has successfully developed the initial prototype of the Dreamchaser, and is currently preparing for its inaugural launch. This achievement not only signifies a triumph for Sierra Space, but also brings exceptionally positive news for NASA and its plans. Furthermore, it poses a challenge to the leading vehicle in NASA's orbital mission, SpaceX's Dragon. Can the Dreamchaser compete with the formidable SpaceX Dragon? Let us discover the answer in today's episode of Science of Space. On November 2, at its headquarters in Louisville, Colorado, Sierra Space made a significant announcement. They officially unveiled their first Dreamchaser prototype, named Tenacity. This prototype is a space plane, designed specifically to transport cargo to the International Space Station. It marks a major milestone in Sierra Space's development history. Tom Weiss, the CEO of Sierra Space, expressed his excitement about this achievement on the company's main website. He stated, "Today, we have reached a profound milestone, in both our company's journey and the future of our industry. This accomplishment has been years in the making and is a testament to our audacious dreaming and tenacious pursuit. The Dreamchaser is not just a product, it represents the indomitable human spirit, determination, and the relentless pursuit of exploration beyond our limits. It symbolizes our unwavering commitment to pushing boundaries and venturing into the unknown." Following the announcement, the Tenacity prototype was relocated to NASA's Neil Armstrong Test Facility, formerly known as the Plum Brook Facility in Ohio. This move was made to conduct environmental testing, an essential step in the development process. The Tenacity prototype shares many structural similarities with the final Dreamchaser design. It measures 9 meters in length, weighs approximately 9 tons when empty, and has a wingspan of 7 meters. Its height is 2 meters, and it can be folded for convenience. The prototype is equipped with a cluster of vortex engines, manufactured by Orbitech, which utilize propane and nitrogen oxide as propellants. Furthermore, the Tenacity prototype is designed to accommodate additional modules, allowing for an increased cargo payload of up to 12,000 pounds, or 5.4 tons. It also features landing wheels, enabling it to land on runways like conventional airplanes. To withstand the extreme temperatures experienced, during atmospheric re-entry, one side of the space plane is protected by silicate bricks, capable of withstanding temperatures exceeding 1,600 degrees Celsius. Additionally, the Dreamchaser's foldable wings play a crucial role in adjusting its landing posture. Ensuring that the side with the protective tiles faces down to directly resist the heat, generated by atmospheric friction. Sierra Space has designed the Tenacity prototype with reusability in mind. It is expected to be reusable for up to 15 missions, showcasing the company's commitment to sustainable space exploration. NASA's test center in Ohio is buzzing with activity, as the Tenacity spacecraft prepares for a series of rigorous environmental tests. These tests will push the spacecraft to its limits, evaluating its ability to withstand the intense vibrations and sounds experienced during a rocket launch. Following this, the spacecraft will face extreme temperature tests, simulating the harsh conditions it will encounter throughout its flight. To conduct these tests, the Tenacity will be placed inside a massive thermal vacuum chamber, creating an environment that mimics the conditions of space. This crucial phase will take approximately 1 to 3 months at the test center, before the Tenacity is transported to the Kennedy Space Center in Florida for its final preparations. The team at NASA is leaving no stone unturned to ensure that the spacecraft is fully prepared for its first mission. Speaking of missions, the Tenacity is part of the Commercial Resupply Services 2 contract, also known as CRS-2, which was awarded to Sierra Space by NASA in January 2016. Under this contract, Sierra Space is responsible for providing at least 7 uncrewed flights to and from the International Space Station. The Tenacity's first mission, known as SNC Demo 1, is scheduled for April 2024. Just like the iconic space shuttle, the Tenacity will be launched into space atop another rocket, specifically the ULA's Vulcan Centaur. In this flight, the Tenacity will be accompanied by the Shooting Star Module, which will significantly increase its payload capacity by an additional 4.5 tons. Once the cargo is safely delivered to the ISS, the Shooting Star module will separate from the spacecraft and burn up in the atmosphere. Meanwhile, the Tenacity will begin its re-entry into the Earth's atmosphere, thanks to its innovative reusable design. As it glides through the atmosphere, it will gracefully touch down on the same runway that was once used by the space shuttle at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. It's an exciting time for space exploration, and the Tenacity is set to make its mark in the history books. Keep an eye out for the first launch of the ULA's Vulcan Centaur rocket, which is scheduled for Christmas this year. We are closely monitoring the Vulcan spacecraft, Vice acknowledged. They are preparing for their first flight, and once the mission data analysis is complete, they will proceed with the second flight. Meanwhile, Sierra Space is working on the next Dreamchaser prototypes, including the DC-200 prototype. This advanced version will have the capability to carry both cargo and a crew of up to 7 astronauts to the ISS. The release of the Tenacity prototype will greatly contribute to Sierra Space's development. It will not only represent the company's brand, but also enable them to fulfill their contract with NASA. Furthermore, even after completing NASA's contract, Sierra Space may still be considered for future missions. This will enhance their competitiveness in the aerospace industry, especially with strong competitors like SpaceX's Dragon in the market. Dreamchaser has several strengths that make it a worthy contender against Dragon. Firstly, its cargo compartment is designed to efficiently arrange and store cargo. In addition to carrying up to 7 astronauts, Dreamchaser offers more seating capacity than Dragon. Although Dragon can also accommodate 7 astronauts, they opted to prioritize additional cargo space, resulting in a reduced seating capacity of 4. One of Dreamchaser's unique features is its landing method. After returning to Earth, it gracefully lands on a runway, similar to a commercial airplane. This method is not only fascinating, but also highly regarded compared to Dragon's ocean landing. Additionally, Dreamchaser can limit re-entry acceleration to 1.5 gigaseconds, ensuring a smoother landing experience. The landing is equipped to handle any potential delicate cargo. These advantages are crucial for Sierra Space to confidently assert that Dreamchaser has the potential to redefine space travel. Furthermore, it will aid in accelerating the company's ongoing space station project. Currently, Sierra Space is constructing an inflatable module system as part of the Orbital Reef project in collaboration with Blue Origin. Despite the challenges faced by this partnership, Sierra Space remains committed to developing this system. Dreamchaser will serve as the primary vehicle for Sierra Space's space station development, even if they continue to maintain their coalition with Blue Origin. Sierra Space recognizes the importance of not relying solely on Blue Origin's New Glenn. The development of Dreamchaser not only benefits Sierra Space but also NASA. Following the retirement of the space shuttle in 2011, NASA and the U.S. aerospace industry faced a challenging period, akin to the Great Depression. They lost the ability to independently send astronauts to the ISS, and had to depend on Russian rockets for nearly a decade. Meanwhile, resupply missions were carried out by other vehicles, such as SpaceX's Dragon and Northrop Grumman's Cygnus. By 2020, with the introduction of Crew Dragon, NASA regained autonomy in sending its crew to the space station. SpaceX's Dragon has become NASA's preferred choice, especially due to its crew launch capability, overshadowing its counterparts. This has had a significant impact on NASA missions. While SpaceX's Dragon brings numerous benefits to NASA, the agency aims to avoid over-reliance on a single vehicle and seeks to increase competition. The recent release of Dreamchaser aligns with NASA's expectations, as it introduces a competitive option to SpaceX's Dragon, granting NASA the freedom to choose the most suitable vehicle for their missions. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.